It's the light of mine, and I'm gonna let it shine. It's the light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. It's the light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine.
Good morning, children, and welcome to this Sunday service teaching. I'd like us that we start with a word of prayer and then we continue. Let's pray. Father, in Jesus' name, we are grateful this morning. Thank you, dear Father, for being together with us the whole week. And thank you, Father, for giving us this day. Lord, we are committing ourselves to you, desiring that you would speak to us, O God. Even as children, we ask you, Lord Almighty, that you will have your way. Dear Lord, even as we sit to hear your word, we ask of you, Jesus, that you minister to us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Let's all of us say amen. Indeed, it's a good day. I'd like to welcome one of us to come and recite a memory verse, and I'm sure we are going to be blessed of the Lord. Welcome.
Start. Praise God. Praise God again. My name is Shekinah and I have a memory verse. John 3:16, and the Bible says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have everlasting life." Thank you.
Praise God. Praise God again. My name is Jeremy Disho. I come from Soul Winning Revival Church, Banana, and I have a memory verse. John 3:16, it says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. Whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life." Amen.
Praise God. Praise God again. My name is Esther Mann from Sorini Revival Church, Banana. I love memory verse. John 3:16. "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have everlasting life." Thank you.
My name is Angel Wangoi Kiburio. I come from Soul Winning Revival Church, ready to present to you a memory verse. John 3:16, and it says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life."
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord again. My name is Victoria Candy. I am in grade 1. I go to Soul Winning Church, Banana Hill, and I have a memory verse. It comes from the book of John 3:16. It says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have everlasting life." Thank you.
My name is Purity Nyambura from Soul Winning Revival Church, Banana Hill, ready to present to you a memory verse from John chapter 3 verse 16, and it says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life." Thank you.
Wow, we thank the Lord for that memory verse. And also I'd like us to invite all of us to sing this song, to celebrate the Lord this song that says, Jesus loved the little children, in the mighty name of Jesus. Wow, that is wonderful. Jesus loved the little children, all the children of the world. Now, today we are going to read about the love of God, about the love of Jesus, and I'm sure we are going to be blessed of the Lord. I'd like us that we read from the book of John chapter 3 and verse 16. It is the verse that we know, and I'm sure that you are going to be blessed of the Lord. The Bible says, for God so loved the world that he gave his one and the only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. Amen. Oh, that's a word of God, that God loved us so much. As we have sung that God loves the little children, all the children of the world. That God loved the world so much that he gave his only begotten Son. That God had only one Son. And that was Jesus. He gave his Son, his only Son, to the world to come and died for us that we may have eternal life. Oh, what a loving Father we have. That God, who is the Father of Jesus, gave us his only Son. He gave the Son to us that we believe in him. And once we believe in him, will not perish, but we have eternal life. Wow, Jesus loved us so much. And he accepted even to come to the world, that he may die for us, that we may have eternal life. You know, as we remember the fall of man in the book of Genesis, when Adam and Eve fell into sin and God chased them away. And God here decided, no, I love the world that I created. I love the people that are in the world. I love the children that are in the world. Let me send Jesus to them, that whoever believes in him will not perish, but have eternal life. Children, Jesus loves us. God loved us with an everlasting love. And that is the reason why he gave Jesus to us, that he may come, that once we believe in him, we'll not perish, but we'll have eternal life. God loves us so much, and he wants us to believe in him, that once we believe in Jesus, once we turn away from our sin and accept Jesus in our hearts, once we turn away from our sin and allow Jesus to come to our hearts, we believe in him, we will have eternal life. The Bible says that he loved us so much, he gave his only begotten Son. And Jesus came to the world, he died for us, that he may come and reconcile us to God. He wants us to come and reconcile us, and he wants us to bring us back to God. And that is why we say that whoever believes in him will not perish, but have eternal life. Maybe you are asking yourself, how can I believe in this Jesus? It's by accepting him as Lord and Savior in your heart. It's by believing in him. It's by turning away from your sin. It's by turning away from your awkward ways. You have been walking in the ways that are not right. As children, you have been walking in the ways that are not good before the eyes of the Lord. And the Lord is saying today that because he loved you and he gave us his only begotten son, that once we believe, once we turn away from our sin, once we turn away from our bad ways that we have been walking in, that we'll have eternal life. God loves us and he would like us that we continue in him, that we may have eternal life. There is this eternal life. We want to promise. There is a promise in the word of God that there is eternal life. And this eternal life, you can only have eternal life by accepting him as Lord and Savior so that we may not perish. You may only ask, I'm only a child. I'm only a teenager. I'm only a youth. Yes. Jesus knows that you're only a children. Jesus knows that you're only a youth, you're only a teenager, and that is why he needs you to believe in him, that you may have this eternal life. We serve a good God. We have a good Father. We have a Father who cares for us. A Father who wants us that we turn our love and we accept him in our lives as a personal Savior so that we may have eternal life. Children, Jesus loves us. Jesus loves the little children. In the Bible, there is a phrase that people wanted to do. They wanted to turn away children from coming to Jesus. And Jesus told them, no, let the children come. Hallelujah. He told them, don't stop them from coming to me. Let the children come to me. There is an invitation for children to come to Jesus. There is an invitation for all of us as children of God to come to Jesus, to believe in Jesus, that we have eternal life. God doesn't want anyone to perish. God doesn't want anyone to perish in sin. God wants us that once we believe in this Jesus, we'll have eternal life. Do you need that eternal life? Children, do you need that eternal life? Yes, we need that eternal life. It is by accepting Jesus as the Lord and Savior. He loves you. He loves you. He loves little children. Come to Jesus. Come and believe in him. And you will not perish. You will have eternal life. It's an honor. It's a privilege to have this Jesus, to have this Jesus in our life. It's a privilege to accept him as Lord and Savior. Yes, believe in him and you will have eternal life. He says that whoever, it doesn't matter where you come from, it doesn't matter where you are, whoever believes in him, whether you are 1 old, whether you are 5 years, whether you are 10, whether you are 20, whether you are 50 years, whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life. Let's accept him in our lives. Let's believe in him. Let's believe in him, that you may have eternal life in the mighty name of Jesus. Let's pray. Precious Father, we are grateful for this morning. Thank you, Jesus Christ, for teaching us about loving you and teaching us about accepting you and teaching us about believing in you that we may not perish, Lord, we ask you even as children that you walk together with us, that you help us to believe in you. In Jesus' name, come to our lives, Lord, and dwell in us, O God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. God bless you. See you next Sunday. Bye-bye.
Let the children come to me. That's what Jesus said. Let the children come to me. That's what Jesus said.